Chris Webber, the rim is still shaking.
Hey guys, what's happening and welcome back to our channel. For a very valid reason, the NBA has the motto, where amazing happens. It perfectly explains what you've seen in the past, what you've seen in the present, and what you'll see in the future from the most talented athletes in the world. For over a half century, the NBA athletes have been thrilling us to our cores and creating accomplishments that we can only think of. Here are the most amazing plays in the history of the NBA. If you start thinking about the plays that captivated you and thought you could never do again, you'd only be proved wrong moments, months, or even years later by a player who's just as talented as the player who did it before. The league has brought out some of the greatest athletes in sporting history and has put together some of the greatest teams as well. Number 6, Allen Iverson.
Put that 45 on a 33 RPM.
Boom. I mean, that's Allen Iverson.
When Allen Iverson was part of the Detroit Pistons, he was a shadow of his former self. His former self was the one who earned the 2001 MVP award and once won 4 winning crowns, winning the title as one of the most consistent scorers to play the game at 6'0" and 165 pounds. His time with the Pistons was forgotten, but he nevertheless managed to leave an impression at the Auburn Hills Palace with a spectacular 45-foot pass that went straight through the legs of Phoenix Suns ahead of Grant Hill and into the hands of Richard Hamilton, who finished the pass with a quick lay-in. Considering the fact that Iverson is more of a scorer than anything else, this pass is only more remarkable that it's already a scorer. Number 5. Chris Paul versus Jason Terry.
And here comes Paul. Oh!
In just 5 years in the league, Chris Paul has already established himself as the best point guard in today's game at 19 points, 10 assists, 5 rebounds, and 2 steals a game for his career so far. Paul can be called a bit of a well-rounded player as he has come close to the elusive quadruple-double in the past. One of his remarkable qualities that don't feature in the stat sheets is his uncanny dribbling ability. CP3 features one of the best crossovers in the league, as well as dribbling and concentrating, and is seen here in a game against division rivals Dallas Mavericks. With the Hornets in double digits, Paul wanted to show off some of his talents by making a fool out of Jason Terry by bringing it through his legs while keeping the dribble on the other end. Number 4, Chris Webber.
Good to me, getting to the first.
Chris Webber is a former American professional basketball player. He's a 5-time NBA All-Star, a 5-time All-NBA team member, a former NBA Rookie of the Year, and a former number 1 overall NBA draftee. Chris Webber was one of the most dominant basketball players at his peak, but making money from a booster might be the only reason Webber doesn't have the highest honor a basketball player can achieve. His NBA resume alone should justify a Hall of Fame bid, regardless of what happened at the college level. Before they were TV personalities, Chris Webber and Charles Barkley were court-appreciated figures who were perennial all-stars. As the two clashed in a battle of titans, Webber managed to get the upper hand of the competition with a bit of NBA's own trash talk. This time, he used his game to chat. With Webber on the fast break and Barkley trailing beside him, Paul decided to do the smart thing and get on the hoop with a thunderous dunk over the top of Barkley. The dunk wasn't quite the strongest drive as Webber carried the ball across his body just before he got up and threw it back. The celebratory arm has lifted a lot of the dunk in one sentence. Man, that just happened. Number 3, Jason Williams.
Williams, and we'll see you on the nightly highlight shows from coast to coast.
If the pass hadn't been to the incompetent Rafe LaFrance, this game would have been rated even higher. Jason Williams is not known for a terrific pass-to-return ratio, but he is known for his high noteworthy throws that looked like the works of Pete Maravich and Magic Johnson combined into one when done perfectly. As the king of Sacramento, Williams spent much of his time producing plays for Peja Stojakovic and Chris Webber while making himself look like the rebirth of Bob Cousy in the process. It was clear what was to come from White Chocolate during the 2000 rookie game as he had a fast split with his teammates on both sides. It seems he was going to pass it to his right with a nifty one behind the back pass, but instead, he used his elbow to hit the ball to his left at the streak of LaFrenz, who was trampled over as he headed to the dunk. Number 2, LeBron James.
James, hot step, three-pointer's good.
LeBron James is a very good player to say the least. In only 7 games in the league, James has had enough accomplishments to make veterans cling and make rookies nervous about what they're expected to do. With 2 consecutive MVP awards and an absurd number of accolades to go along with them, LeBron has a bright future ahead of him and a few championships could be on the way now that he signed with Miami Heat. In quite possibly one of the greatest playoff performances of all time, James decided to take the game into his own hands in the 2007 Detroit Pistons season. Not only did he lead the Cleveland Cavaliers to a win by hitting the winning layup in double overtime, but he had already hit the team's last 25 points. Let's try and put that into perspective. Most teams don't score 25 points in a quarter, but James somehow managed to score almost a quarter of points in a row and then a few. No point, however, was more electrical than his roaring jam over the 6'11" Rasheed Wallace, who made the mistake of trying to contend with an athletic monster. Number 1, Daryl Dawkins. The backboards are no longer made of glass for a reason, and you can thank Daryl for that. With 6'11" and 255 pounds, Daryl was already a force to be reckoned with in the NBA. He wasn't too much of a scorer, but more recognized as a bruiser. In fact, Daryl recorded the NBA record for the most number of fouls in a season with 386 in the 1983-84 season. Considering he played 81 games that season, that's almost 5 fouls per contest. Fouls are not what the NBA world is known for. What we know about Daryl is that he is the first NBA player ever to destroy the NBA regulatory basket. On November 11, 1979, Daryl sent the players running after he broke the backboard glass on a thunderous slam that sent shards to the courthouse. It wasn't over though, as Daryl repeated the feat on December 6, 1979, shattering the board and taking the rim down this time. The league decided that the players would be fined from now on for breaking the board before finally institutionalizing unbreakable backboards. So let us know some of your greatest plays in NBA history in the comments section below. And while you do that, don't forget to hit us up with a like and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already so you can catch up on more juicy NBA related content from our channel in the future. Until next time guys, take care and goodbye.